Officials at California's San Quentin prison still are trying to piece together exactly what happened and how in that attempted prison break yesterday in which three convicts and three guards died. One of the dead convicts was George Jackson of the self-styled Soledad Brothers. Jackson was 29. He became nationally known and a symbol to black revolutionaries in this country after his book on prison life, Soledad Brother, was published last year. Terry Drinkwater reports.
Jackson apparently led the attempted escape using a gun somehow smuggled to him inside the prison. It all lasted not much more than 30 seconds. Three white guards and two white inmates were killed, their throats slit. Three other guards were wounded. Then Jackson came running out of the maximum security cell block and he was cut down by another guard firing from some distance. It was the worst violence in the history of this prison, and only the latest in a long series of killings involving and related to what are known as the Soledad Brothers, a group of three black inmates originally held at Soledad Prison. A guard was killed there, and a second guard killed here at San Quentin earlier this summer. That was the first guard killed at San Quentin in 19 years. The victim was, at the time, guarding an inmate who was a key witness in the first Soledad Brothers case. Jackson was called a dilettante revolutionary, a murderer by the warden. Two other Soledad brothers were also involved in yesterday's attempted escape. And so was Rochelle McGee, who, along with Angela Davis, is charged with murder and kidnapping in the Marin County Courthouse shootout last year. At the Marin Civic Center, Jackson's younger brother was killed by officers after he allegedly smuggled guns into the courtroom. The bodies of the slain guards and the white inmates indicated they were slashed across the throat and neck. All but one body was found in Jackson's own cell. The weapon, a toothbrush with a razor blade attached, was identified today. Weapons like that are often found in prison shakedowns. The extraordinary breach of prison security was how Jackson got his revolver. This is a maximum security prison. The warden's investigators suspect a male visitor who saw Jackson early yesterday somehow concealed the weapon and passed it to Jackson. At a press conference this afternoon, prison officials talked about black militancy at San Quentin.
This is a copy of Right On, whatever that might be. It has a picture of the Black Panther, so I assume it belongs to the Black Panther Party. Under state law 2600, we are required to allow inmates to receive anything that's accepted for mailing in the United States mail. I might point out to you, if the officers see the inmates reading this, understandably this makes them some disturbed and adds to their anger.
Even with the new militancy among the black prisoners, the escape couldn't have happened without a serious lapse in security. That is under high-level investigation. Terry Drinkwater, CBS News, San Quentin.
The FBI arrested 20 persons in Camden, New Jersey early today and charged them with trying to steal draft records from the federal building there. We have a report from Gary Shepard.
The government says that eight of the defendants entered the Camden Federal Building from the back, using a ladder to avoid an alarm, then climbing up to the fifth floor to break into a draft office. When they were arrested, the government says they had already lowered some draft records out the window in mail sacks. The Reverend Milo Billman, a Lutheran minister, was one of three clergymen arrested in the case. He was released without bail, along with two others, but two Roman Catholic priests chose to go to jail with the 17 other defendants who are